In the early 20th century, the areas surrounding Bushwick, Ridgewood and Glendale were thriving with old movie theatres. It was the golden age of silent films, and many of these theatres doubled with vaudeville acts as well. The culture around going to the movies in the early 20th century was vastly different to how it is nowadays. Back then there was no television, and radio was in its infancy. So going to the movie house was a frequent form of family entertainment. The initial theatres that you see in this opening monologue are theatres that I have previously shown on this channel. They are the RKO Madison, the Ridgewood Theatre, the Grandview, and the Oasis. You can find the full details on those theatres in the description, where I will post a link to the respective videos that each theatre can be seen in. This is a little hobby of mine, or you could even call it a passion. I love to learn about the previous history of places and buildings in New York City, even if those places themselves no longer exist in a physical form. In this video, for example, I am going to show you an additional 6 old movie theatres to go along with the 4 that you were seeing in this opening introduction. Out of the 6, only 3 original buildings remain. The other 3 were demolished, so we will just be visiting the locations of where those theatres once stood. Now, this video isn't going to be covering every single theatre from these neighbourhoods. There are still many more that I will locate and show at a later time. But I do hope that you will find the descriptions and the brief histories of each theatre interesting. While the COVID pandemic is still affecting the New York City area, and cases continue to rise, I will continue to focus on filming in Queens and Brooklyn. There is really no need for me to go into Manhattan just yet, which can wait until next year. The important thing is to leave Manhattan alone for essential workers. Most of my New York history videos will be set in Manhattan, but this will allow me the time to build and grow my channel by focusing on local places. Let's be honest, Brooklyn and Queens are individually bigger than some world cities anyway. So without further ado, let's explore the 6 old movie theatres that I am going to feature in this video. First up is the site of the former Belvedere Theatre in Glendale, Queens. This theatre is one of the few that I don't have an exact date on, but it was open as far back as 1922 and remained open until the 1950s. The building itself is the original building, and if you look closely enough, you can still see the name Belvedere etched into the concrete up above the main entrance. 6 years ago, this church was also the site of a memorial service that saw 20,000 or more police officers attend, along with many thousands of citizens. The memorial service was for Officer Rafael Ramos, a New York City police officer, who along with his partner, Wenjian Liu, were murdered in cold blood as they sat in their parked car. The callous act was felt by many in New York, and indeed the nation. At the time, I lived 7 blocks away from here, and you could hardly move in the streets that day. One of the speakers at this church on that day was none other than Vice President Biden, the soon-to-be new President of the United States. It is somewhat of a coincidence that the man stood next to him on the street that day was none other than Rudy Giuliani, the man who is currently leading the wacky conspiracy theories that are trying to prevent Joe Biden from becoming president. One final note about this story that you might find interesting. The other officer who was murdered, Wen Jianlu, had only been married for 2 months at the time of his death. They preserved sperm from his body, and 2.5 years after his death, his wife gave birth to their daughter. Here she is with baby Angel, along with the officer's parents, who lost their only child on that fateful night, with their granddaughter. The second theatre on our trip today is in Ridgewood, Queens. This building here was once the Parthenon Theatre that was opened in 1921 with a showing of the movie Outside the Law, starring Priscilla Dean. Also worth noting that when the theatre opened, it was located in Brooklyn, but after rezoning, it ended up in Queens. This theatre remained open until 1959, and it then became a bowling alley. The interior nowadays looks nothing like it did during the days that it was a theatre, but the exterior of the building remains. One can only imagine what is underneath the panelling. Almost certainly there would be remnants of the Parthenon if the outside was stripped down. The third theatre on the list is just a theatre location. I've not been able to dig up any old photos of the site when it was a theatre. This location right here was once the Ritz Theatre that opened in the early 1920s. Quite a normal time frame for movie houses to open. Unlike other movie houses though, this one did not last for too long. Quite likely because of the many other movie theatres in the area, the Ritz closed down sometime in the 1930s. The best that I can do for an image is from 1939, when the movie theatre had become a furniture store, with perhaps the one remaining remnant from the movie theatre being the hanging sign outside the building. Next up is yet another location where the original theatre was torn down. This time we are at the location of the Glenwood Theatre that operated between 1921 and the early 1960s, when this theatre too became a bowling alley. This is the only image that I have of the Glenwood Theatre from 1941. After the bowling alley closed, the whole site was demolished, and a post office was built at the location. Now, I have been to this post office many times, as it is the main post office for the area, and I lived in this area for nearly 20 years. What I will say is that you need the patience of a saint in this post office. I have seen so many arguments and near fights in here. Even myself, I'm a very mild-mannered man, but holy smokes can this place get to you. They always seem dreadfully understaffed, and I think that it would be fair to say that customer service is not one of their priorities. The fifth of the six theatres that we are covering today is the site of the Acme Theatre in Glendale, Queens. The theatre originally opened as the Alpha Theatre sometime around 1917 and changed its name to the Acme Theatre around the mid-1930s. Up until the exterior of the building was painted with this gaudy looking puke yellow colour, you could still see the Acme name engraved in stone at the top of the building. Aside from the facade, where you can make out the remnants of how the theatre once looked, the marquee in front of the building also still exists, which now, of course, has the supermarket name on it. As this was a German neighbourhood at the time, the Acme would also feature frequent German double features for many years. The Acme closed sometime in the mid-1950s, and at one point it became a church and also a catering hall. There isn't too much information online regarding this theatre, but you can at least see from the exterior what the building once looked like when it was a theatre. The last theatre on our trip today is the Whitney Theatre on Fresh Pond Road. This theatre only operated between 1912 and the late 1920s, and it was also the home to vaudeville performers of the day. Now, the structure that we are looking at almost certainly wasn't the Whitney. More than likely, the Whitney, which was located right where you are looking at the moment, was probably torn down in the 1920s. At one point, it was a children's restaurant, and the exterior is quite likely the remnants of that restaurant. The Oasis Theatre opened just a few blocks from here in 1927. So it is quite possible that the competition was too much for the Whitney to survive. The theatre did leave us with one thing, though, that can never be changed, and that is this awesome looking picture right here. Isn't this just a fabulous looking image of Fresh Pond Road before the elevated railway was made right above it? At the time, there was a ground level train station, and the Whitney was right next door to it.
Did you hear today? You were nice. You look nice, man. Good fucking love you.